This is another year Santua. Yeah, this is his town, Ejisu. So if you want to take a picture, please just go ahead.
Wow. Also, Kwabna, tell us some of the history about Ya Nana Santua.
Who is Ya Santua? Kwabna, who is that?
I'll talk about it. People are taking pictures, so when you talk about it, when you start, they will not listen.
Yes, family, the statue of the warrior queen in the Jitsu Ya Santua of the Ashanti Empire. And our tour guide Kwabna is going to give you a full history as we circling around. Yes, family, we're in Kumasi, live on Revolutionary Cam. And we are on another journey of a lifetime, Ghana, Togo, Benin, November 2017.
When you get to the post office, let me know.
Okay.
Okay.
Kwabna, can you back up? Kwabna, can you back up, please?
Oh.
Right.
So that was the statue. Let's hit
okay.
Family.
I know some of you know or have a knowledge about Nana Ya Santua. Yeah, some of you have read about him and you've seen some movies and other things. But Nana Ya Santua was the queen mother of this town called Ejisu. Yeah, Ejisu. In 1890, the governor of the Gokus came to Kumasi and he needed a golden stool. He said the queen needs the golden stool because the queen is in charge of Ghana. So anything that is good have to go to London. And they refused giving him the golden stool. He came again asking for the golden stool and they refused giving it to him on several occasions. So what happened is that in 1900, the woman declared a war on the British. When the British came, and they needed the golden stool. Now, 4 years before that is in 1896, Governor Hudson brought a lot of soldiers to Kumasi here so they can search and pick the golden stool. The king of Ashanti and his elders were arrested and sent to exile to Elmina and from Elmina to Seychelles. They just imprisoned them there because they refused to give them the golden stool. So 4 years after that, they came again, we need the golden stool. And because the Ashantis doesn't want to fight, they went and hid the golden stool. The queen mother was not the occupant of the golden stool. She was not the guide of the golden stool. But she knew the essence of the golden stool. So she made sure that although the king is not there, a lot of cheese has been taken away, the golden stool would not be taken away. So she kept it, she herself and others kept it somewhere. Governor Hussein came again from Accra, needed the golden stool. And in our tradition, if someone cross a sword or machete or a stick in front of you, the person has declared a war. Yeah. So during the meeting, then the woman declared a war. That it is better for us to die and save the goodies too than to give it to you and we will be alive. So she refused giving them the goodies to, and she said, tomorrow by this time, the dead people will get, the dead men and women will get husbands and wives. When we also say this, meaning that they have laid down their lives and they are prepared to die. And then she crossed the sword in front of the governor, meaning a war has been declared. The governor went, brought soldiers from Sierra Leone, from London, from a whole lot of places, that they should come and fight the Ashantis, because they knew that the Ashantis are warriors. Many times the Ashantis have defeated them. Although they have a superior weapon, Ashantis also use a superior mind to outwit them. They declared a war, and this war was a very fierce war. Yaa Santua was arrested. She was arrested because one of her bodyguards was arrested, sent to Accra. They fed her, they didn't kill him. They fed him, they took good care of him, and they tricked him that we will send you to London, we will do this for you, we will do this for you if you tell us where the goodies tool is. So he also revealed where the Queen Mother is hidden. And they brought, according to his some history, he said they brought 30,000 soldiers. Some history also says 1,400 soldiers. Some history also says, so there is no accurate number of soldiers that they brought to go and arrest one old lady. So this shows you, or this tells us how strong the Ashantis are. When she heard that the soldiers were closing in, they went and hid the goodies to from where they kept it. So even the guy who went and revealed where she was hidden doesn't know where the golden suit is. The golden suit can be here. Tomorrow they move it from here to another place. So they hid the golden suit, and Queen Mother was arrested. Because they arrested her, they built a small fort, an inland fort we will see today. All the forts that were built by the Europeans are the coasts. This is the only fort inland. So they kept her there for some time. And Ashantis, the queen is gone, his elders are gone, great people are gone, but still organized themselves to go and fight the British. So they saw that the Ashantis were coming. They put her and elders, went to Elmina Castle, kept them in Elmina Castle. And from Elmina Castle, Ashantis have to trek. It's about 3.5 hours drive. They walk to Elmina Castle to go and fight the British. And the British saw that these people are very strong. They picked her from there to Seychelles Island, imprisoned her there, where she finally lost her life, or she died. Because of her bravery, in Ghana, if you're a woman and you show a sign of bravery, they give you the name Yaa Santua. They say, why are you like Yaa Santua? You know, yeah. She did quite well. The coding stool is not a stool that you can put your feet or your buttocks or whatever on. According to history, a woman gave birth to a boy, and when the boy came out, his hands were closed. And in the olden days, even now, some people do it. In some areas, they do it in Africa. That when they give birth to a child, they take him to the suicide, they take him to a lot of places to ask of the child's future profession. Is he coming to say, or when he comes, within a short time, he will leave. In our tradition, if a child, when a mother gave birth to a child, and then she passed on before the 8th day, there is no funeral. The child is just a visitor. A visitor comes and goes away. So it's just a visitor. He just came to say hi to the family and is gone. But after 8 days, before the naming ceremony and other ceremony will take place. So this child, they took him to a place, and then they interpreted that he's a savior. He's come to deliver some people. He was sent to deliver some people. And they took him when he was growing to a Kwapimira in the eastern region, a place so that he would go through the royal priesthood. He performed so many wonders. I will not have time to go to a certain place else. We will show you some of the wonders that he performed here in Kumasi. He took a palm nut, 3 weeks, and all the palm nuts, fell on a straight line. And he said, this palm nut is our fingers. And that's the meaning is that this palm nut will grow. You see the thumb and all the five fingers there. And he says that human beings are not the same. Even if they are from the same womb, two people are never the same. Right now when you go there, it's still there. And then you see the thumb, you see the middle one very long, and then the small one very short. They all grew, but they don't eat the fruits. It is best that spread those fruits all over. Yeah, it's still there.